Welcome back everyone, and welcome to my channel if you're new here. Today I will make you a pantry tour of my, wow, the sun is shining. Okay, this is gonna be really, really annoying because my camera is in manual setting and the clouds keep getting in and out, but we're thankful for the sun. Today I want to show you what I keep in my pantry food-wise. I did another video which was what's in my Parisian fridge. I'm just gonna wait a little bit because otherwise I'll be like washed out like a ghost. I don't need to look any more pale. Oh my god! Okay, we're gonna have to deal with this today. I have just three things to mention before I get things started. First of all, yes, I'm vegan, so there's not gonna be any animal product in this video. Second thing is I live in Paris, so if you're not from France or Europe, you might not like find similar brand. And then the third thing, I am really conscious about my impact on the environment, and I'm trying my best all the time to reduce day by day things that I can reduce. But I'm not calling myself a zero waste or a very like perfect on sustainability person. I try to buy in bulk as much as I can, and you will see like a lot of things are without plastic, or if it's plastic it's compostable. But I do have packaged stuff, and this is like the only disclaimer that I'll do out of this video, and it's not to justify myself, it's more to kind of show you that it's not because you don't have anything perfect yet that you can't start, you know, living a better, more impactful lifestyle. And hopefully by the time goes by, the option get broader, and just like still happen to me that I need to buy like a package of oats rather than in bulk, and I don't like give myself so much hard time for it. Anyways, let's get started. I'm pretty lucky because I live in a studio, but my kitchen is like a separate room, which is really nice because I cook a lot. Oh, there's one thing I didn't mention as well, is that you might be impressed by the number of different things that I store. It's because I create recipes, okay? And I love cooking, and anyone that loves cooking loves to try and experience new ingredients. But if your goal is just being healthy and vegan, like, you definitely don't need as much things that I have. It's just to show you what I personally have. This is the overview of my keto kitchen. And I have a really nice view of Paris outside, which I won't show you because some sneaky people might actually check where that is and find me, and I'm very, very scared of that kind of thing. Here's the door. You're going in the kitchen. What do you see? Three top pantries, my fridge, two bottom, and this I added, which I'll show you what it is. And then on the right, two bottom ones and two top ones. In this one, like, there's nothing to show you. This is my oven and my pans and everything. Like, there's really not much. And this one is more bowls and tupperwares and stuff. So this is not my pantry where I keep my food. As I'm a short person, I still haven't like grown up. Okay, so in that top one, this is the shelf where it's the most kind of random things, but it's the easy and grab things, which are the salt when I'm cooking, my supplements, and then baking stuff. So I have cane sugar. It was a mulberry thing, but since it's plastic, I thought I would reuse it, and now I just use it for bulk. Coconut syrup and coconut sugar, which is my favorite sugar. It's not as high in the right? At the back, I have some baking yeast and some vanilla from Tahiti. I also keep my chocolate in there. Oh yeah, supplements. You probably are interested in that. I take some B12, of course. Like, if you're vegan and you're not taking B12, even if you're like a vegetarian or even like an omnivore person, you should take your B12. Carotene, of course, they're vegan. Probiotic and something for my hair because I had like a lot of fallout last year of my hair, and I'm just taking that. I also have magnesium sometimes because as a yoga teacher, my muscle gets sore sometimes, so this is good for at night. At the back, I have raw cacao powder and also normal cacao powder, which is much cheaper, but I use in baking stuff. And this one I use in raw stuff, which has more nutrients. Up here is my pasta shelf. Red lentils pasta, which cooks super fast and it's higher in fiber and higher in protein than normal pasta. Nutritional yeast, I have a big jar of it. And then this is normal pasta, macaroni, spaghetti. I also keep some soba noodle or udon noodle, which I love. But yeah, this is my pasta shelf. And at the back, I do have like random things. Soy, protein like that, which I don't really use a lot, honestly. And then this flour, which is very random. It's lupin. I don't even know if you know this name, but lupin flour. Try and get recipes working with it. And then I have like lasagna and other type of pasta. Up there are my tea towel and my almond cow. All right, in here are all my grains and my beans. Oh yeah, I'm not gluten-free, so like don't expect to see gluten-free stuff in here. This is normal wheat couscous. Green lentils that I eat like every week for sure. Buckwheat, we eat that a lot in our house. I mean, we is me and my stomach. Red lentils, I use that in curry, that in soups, in dal, just really, really nice. And this is quinoa. My preference is for red quinoa, but and then this is basmati rice. I have special kind of rice like risotto rice and black rice, but those are not things that I use a lot. And oh, what do I have here? Yeah, I have this thing that I bought, or maybe my mom bought it for me, and I still haven't used it because I don't really know how to cook it. I need to come up with something. Okay, so up there are my flours. Most of them I can buy in bulk, so that's really cool. Of course I write what they are because I mean those kind of thing, like I can know what they are, but that not really. So I also write in French and English, although I think this miss an H. And I say if they're gluten-free or not because this really helps me when I make recipes for you guys, so I know what's gluten-free that I can make or not. Coconut flour, good for dessert stuff. Almond flour, also for dessert. This is more for like savory and sweet. This is for both. This is for savory, and this is really nice to make like egg-like stuff. All right. We're moving to here, which is a little bit of a mess, but it's a mess that I know. I don't know if you guys are amazed by this, but yeah, I find that when you have like very deep things, it's really not practical. So I invested in that kind of like tray that goes around, and it's just like much more easier. So yeah, this part is more like breakfast slash salad topping, smoothie bowls topping, nutrition in terms of micro elements, if that makes sense. Although like I don't see my food all the time like this, but I know that everything that's in there I can add a little sprinkle and it'll boost what I eat. Almonds, pistachios, cashews, hazelnuts, some slivered almonds, some Brazilian nuts, which I have one every day for selenium, is really important. Chia seeds and pumpkin seeds. On the other tray, we have some dates. Usually I have way more. Goji berry, cranberries, sunflower seeds, gomasio, sesame seeds, coconut shreds. And then I have some pretty flowers to put some flowers on my cakes and stuff. Oh, I do have rice paper because they're not feeding anywhere else. This is way too big. But aside from that, I have some cacao nibs. I have two protein powders. I'm not working with Vivo. Green powder from Welco, which is a really nice one. I also put it in there. Coconut water in powder, which I've used to make my gels when I run the marathon, and since then I haven't really used them, but I should. Okay, never know how it's called in English, but this is a green powder, again, tasty and pretty healthy for you. So yeah, I'm adding this to my smoothies most of the time. This is a flour of pumpkin seeds, and it's super high in protein, you guys. 60 grams of protein per 100 gram. Have some dal, quinoa puffs, which I haven't used. I need to find a recipe to use them or create a recipe. I have a big jar of oats. Now the reason why it's not at the front of my pantry is because I bought it in bulk and I still have this much more. I first use that and then I'll use what's in the jar. And I have Hawaiian spirulina too. I swear, they're conspiring against me. Ruiz. I'm gonna make a video. They're working. Am I ever gonna be able to make a video without the sound of work in the background? Moving on. This is gonna be really quick because I'm not gonna go through my tea, but this is my tea section slash herbal tea. Up there is my nut butter shelf with tahini, cashew butter, sometimes have almond butter more than cashew, peanut butter and coconut butter homemade that I made, and the recipe is on my Instagram if you want it. And then I have some matcha because it doesn't feel really in there. Those are all my spices and it's really not interesting, like, at all. Let's start. Well, there is my cleaning products. They're not toxic, so I can keep them next to my food. But let's start. I have some apple cider vinegar, coconut oil, and olive oil are just like the most common things I use. Then I have different oils plus alcohol on the back, but yeah, I don't use them as much. A lot of apple sauce. I can make my own, honestly. I just needed some new jars, so I bought them. I have some Oatly because I just wanted to try it out. It just came out in my shop. In there, I have all my canned beans. Have this one, which I buy at an Asian supermarket to make meat-like stuff. And I'm really, really keen to try it. So I love chickpeas and I have like a lot of them. I love also red kidney beans. I can't find in glass jar, unfortunately. Don't eat a lot of corn, so from time to time I'll get a can of corn. I always have some sort of coconut milk, tomatoes in cans, and I have like some chips and stuff like that at the back, but not really much because it's not something I eat a lot of. And I have some olives there, some soy cream. So now you know all the secrets of my kitchen. Next time, if you want, I can show you my appliance, like my blenders, my robots, everything. If you have any questions of any kind, leave them in the comments below. Before I forget, I do have a guide about veganism in France. So if you're interested in that, if you're coming to France and you're wondering where to shop and what to bring and things like that, it will help you a lot. Oh, I also have a free pantry guide that you can grab and download with the link that I'll put below too. Yeah, just to make it easier for you to eat healthy and vegan. So thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys real soon.